helping hand, I'll lean upon. This is my prayer, my humble plea. May the Lord be ever with me. There is no death, though eyes grow dim. There is no fear when I'm near to Him. I'll lean on Him forever, and He'll forsake me never. He will not fail me as long as my faith is strong. I'll take His hand, I'll talk with God, He'll understand. I'll pray to Him each day, to Him, and He'll hear the words that I say. His hand will and I'll never walk alone while I walk with God.
Kevin Quattlebaum, so very much for singing this special hymn for us today, a hymn of faith, but also of the faith and honoring the faith of Nancy as we draw together to remember and to celebrate her life today. On behalf of the entire family and you as friends of Nancy, I welcome you in the name of the risen Christ as we are gathered here this afternoon to celebrate and remember her life and to remember what God is doing in this event that we call death. For your prayers through recent years, especially in the last months, for your support in so many ways that has gone especially to Nancy and to Betty, they want to thank you so very deeply and so very much. It means so much to bring comfort and to bring strength in times such as these. With that in mind, let us hear these words of support and greeting from our Lord Jesus Christ. Dying, Christ destroyed our death. Rising, Christ restored our life. Christ will come again in glory. As in baptism, Nancy Lou Stanley put on Christ, so in Christ may Nancy be clothed with glory. Here now, dear friends, we're God's children. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. But we know that when He appears, we shall be like Him, because we shall see Him as He is. Those who have this hope purify themselves as Christ is pure. Jesus said, I am resurrection and I am life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, yet shall they live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. And I hold the keys of hell and death. Because I live, you will live also. Friends, we have gathered here this afternoon to praise God and to witness to our faith as we remember and celebrate the life of Nancy Lou Stanley, we come together in grief, acknowledging our human loss and asking that God may grant us grace in our pain to find hope and comfort in his presence and in death, resurrection. Would you join me in a moment of prayer? Maker of time and space, God who was before time and place, we thank you for the gift of years. We're grateful for all that gives shape and design, for the dependable round of days in the annual cycle of seasons of the heart. We thank you for fresh beginnings and pray that in the use of these your gifts, we may find closeness with your timeless spirit. As we gather here in this time and place to remember and honor our sister Nancy, enable us so to put our trust in you that our spirits may grow calm and our hearts be comforted. Lift our eyes beyond the shadows of earth and help us to see the light of eternity. We thank you for the gracious memories which gather about the life of our dear friend Nancy, for the kindly deeds and thoughts, for the love freely given and the love modestly received. Sanctify this sorrow to those who most deeply mourn, and especially Betty, her beloved twin, who, though different from each other, were perfect soulmates to encourage and enrich each other through life. We're grateful that Nancy was spared to receive so many evidences of the honor and love in which she was held. And we're most grateful for the legacy of love, faith, and service that she has left us. So enable us to think of her as no farther away, dear Father, than your presence, and that very near. In the precious name of him who died and rose again for us, even Jesus our Savior, amen. I invite you to find a hymn book on the back of the pew in front of you, and we're going to sing together the song number 314, In the Garden, and I would invite you to stand as you're able as we do that.
I come to the garden alone, while the dew is still on the roses, and the voice I hear falling on my ear, the Son of God discloses, and he walks with me and talks with me, and he tells me I am his own. And the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever known. He speaks, and the sound of his voice is so sweet. The birds hush their singing, and the melody that he gave to me within my heart is singing. And he walks with me, and he talks with me, and he tells me I am. And the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever known. I'd in the garden with him, though the night around me be falling, but he bids me go through the voice of hope. His voice to me is calling, and he walks with me, and he talks with me, and he tells me I am his own, and the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever known.
In just a moment, Betty, my wife Betty, and I are going to share some beloved scripture passages for this day to our comfort and our strength and our hope. But before we do, just a brief word, personal word about Nancy from both of us, and same thoughts would come out of your hearts and your minds and your mouth as well as ours, but these are some of ours, mine in particular. We know death is never an easy thing, but because of our love for Nancy and for each other, we do come to a time in a service such as this to honor Nancy, to remember her, and to hear what God is doing in the event we call death. And I would remind you that this is not a final tribute, for the most lasting memorial is not carved on stone, not even in a service such as this, but is the memorial left in the hearts and the minds of those who knew and loved Nancy. Betty and I didn't know Nancy during what we would understand and reasonably expect to be their most active years of their primary work and their professions, or those most active years of their travels and their camping, which we understand was one of the greatest joys of their lives, with friends, socializing, enjoying nature and the beauty that God has provided for all of us. We would come a little late on the end of those kinds of things, or at the church as well. We know that they were most active in so many ways before we ever saw that firsthand and participated in it with them. But we do know from our subsequent visits with them and getting to know them through the years later that they grew up with their parents, with their family, in the Presbyterian Church in Dallas, and they were all active there before coming to this church out of friendship that they had made with persons during these camping experiences and growing friendship and fellowship to their life. But finally, Betty and I did arrive here as their pastor in 1992. So we immediately began to hear those stories, and the more we heard, the more they kind of would become inflated, I think. But we all know who knew them, how active and how involved, and especially in social relationships and loving and enjoying people, both of them were and still are, even as Nancy is telling God some of her experiences and some of her jokes today, and they have a lot to catch up on, so we can be sure that Nancy is busy in the spiritual body that God has provided for her. But at any rate, we soon came to know what a friendly person Nancy was, and how she did love people, how fun she was to be around. and to be able to engage with that, with both of them, always. And it's very difficult, as it is for you, as for us. As we talk about one today, we're talking about both, because even though different, they are also very similar, the closest as twin sisters. And though different, gave great enrichment and fellowship with their ups and downs, as any siblings will be from time to time, to enrich each other's life and provide that ongoing enrichment and joy that only twins, I think, not having been there myself, but from what we have already always known and thought, special, very, very special, and they were too. You'll notice even on your worship guide today, Nancy was always smiling. This is not the Nancy that most of you know. She's solemn looking in this picture, though it's a great picture, but Nancy was always smiling, always happy, except when she wasn't. And we can all relate to that, and we are all, that's any of us. But she was a fun-loving person, and sassy, and as I said, just fun to be around and to be with. She and Betty has enjoyed very much. We learned when we came here, as maybe some of you, probably a lot of you, when you first met them and were becoming acquainted with them, they were mischievous, and they liked to catch you. Which one am I? You know, what's my name? And that's happened to all of us, hasn't it, Susan? Laughing there, because it took us some time to find out the nuances of the physical attributes to let us kind of catch on to which one was which. And they enjoyed that, got great fun out of it. Nancy was a lover of people, and they both love the church once they arrived here, especially the Koinonia class. Some of your friends are sitting behind you, and other activities in the church, always cooperating and participating and helping with Vacation Bible School, with missions, and so many things to encourage and to help God in the task that we have in the church to be His body here in the world. They were both, Nancy as Betty, both lovers of animals. And as you well know, especially their beloved Inky and Max, who preceded them in death, which was very, very difficult. Though they were inseparable and loyal, and both precious child of God. And that's what we're here to celebrate today. And so we're going to share a few scriptures that have been chosen today that celebrates that faith that Nancy lived and that gave her the strength and the comfort for life. So Betty will begin for us.
The first scripture today is Psalm 121. I lift up my eyes to the hills. From where will my help come? My help comes from the Lord who made the heaven and the earth. He will not let your foot be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber. He who keeps Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all evil. He will keep your life. The Lord will keep your going out and your coming in from this time on and forevermore.
And then from the prophet Isaiah, the 40th chapter, verses 28 through 31. Why do you say, O Jacob, and speak, O Israel? My way is hidden from the Lord, and my right is disregarded by my God. Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even youth will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength, and they shall mount up with wings like eagles, and they shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint.
John 14:1-7. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way, and you know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, how can we know where you're going? How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. I'll just know you. You will know my Father also. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. And the 27th verse. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid.
And finally, from the book of Revelation, the 21st chapter, verses 1 through 7. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them as their God. They will be his peoples, and God himself will be with them. And here especially, these words for today. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more, for the first things have passed away. And the one who was seated on the throne said, See, I'm making all things new. And he said, Write this, for these words are trustworthy and true. Then he said to me, It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty I will give water as a gift from the spring of the water of life. Those who conquer will inherit these things, and I will be their God, and they shall be my children.
Timothy 4:7 and following. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, there is reserved for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give me on that day, and not only to me, but also to all who have longed for his appearing. Amen.
The word of God. Thanks be to God. Amen. Expression of faith and desire that Nancy had for God. Just a closer walk with thee.
Just
just a closer walk with thee. Granted, Jesus, is my plea. Daily walking close to thee, let it be, dear Lord, let it be. Through this world of toils and snares, if I falter, Lord, who cares? Who with me my burden shares? None but thee, dear Lord, none but thee. Just a closer walk with thee. Granted, Jesus, is my plea. Daily walking close to thee, let it be, dear Lord, let it be. When my feeble life is o'er, time for me will be no more. Guide me gently, safely o'er, to thy kingdom shore, to thy shore. Just a closer walk with thee. Granted, Jesus, is my plea. Daily walking close to thee, let it be, dear Lord, let it be.
I'm sure from all of us, and especially Nancy during her lifetime, I feel that we're very privileged and we're honored today to have Nancy's hospice chaplain with us, Chaplain John Abraham, who endeared himself, and as he has to so many people, I'm sure, to Nancy and to Betty, especially during these last weeks, and was such a comfort and a source of strength to them. And he's going to share with us today any words personally he wants to share, as well as words of comfort and hope from God's holy word today for all of us. So, John, we thank you so very much for being here today. Thank you. You'll just go.
First of all, I wanted to thank you, Dr. Mike, Reverend Mike, and family. Invited me to say things about Nancy. And as you all know that Nancy was admitted in our hospice, Rejoice Hospice, on 7th of January, 2022. And our nurse went there that day and do all the initial assessments and offer them about a chaplain visit and a social worker visit. Initially, they were a little reluctant to accept, but our nurse said our chaplain is able to come and do certain assessment, and that's it. And you don't have to let him come again and things like that. So I got a chance to go and meet with them on 11th of January, and as we built up our friendship, and that was so deep in my heart, and I got a great friends, Nancy and Betty, and we started with a lot of cultural things and sharing with them, and they love to listen to our lives, and of course they know Dr. Wengelil for a long time, and she is the their primary doctor, and we connect a lot of things, and we talk about a lot of things. And I, before I leave the place, I asked them what the chaplain wanted to do for you, and Nancy said they didn't have the communion for a while, and they would like to have the communion. So I decided to bring the communion, and they were celebrated together, and I was still remembering the humor sense of Nancy, and we were laughing together, and understanding the fact that she's declining, and there's a time that she's not taking any food and water, and that's the time I met Martha there. And all of a sudden, all the friends come together and helping Betty. That was great, and I was so impressed by that. Even, you know, our life is a very small span on earth. We will be able to make a lot of money sometimes and sometimes few, but we need to know that the relationships between us is more important than anything that you could make. And I thank God for Martha and friends like Joanne. And all of them were always coming together. As you all know, that Nancy went with the Lord on 26th of February. And Betty was heartbroken. And I went there and sit with her and spend time with her and try to make her understand that she is with the Lord. The Word of God says, I am absent from the body and present with the Lord. And she was in the presence of the Lord that we could able to know through the Word of God. Also, I recited one more verse that day, that from Psalm 23, even though we walk through the valley of shadow of death, I will not fear evil, for you are with me, your rod and staff that comfort me. You know, death and separation is so hurtful, all of us. And when I was 7 years old, I lost my dad in a car crash. And now, 43 years after, I still missing him in my life. When things like Christmas and main times in my life, I miss him so badly. So we could have the great hope in God. That's what I wanted to tell you, Betty, that even if she's gone to the presence of God, we have the great hope in God that she is in his presence, wherever he is. Theologically different, you know, differentiate our lives, but we should know that he is in the presence of God. That is the most important thing. And the road and staff that comfort our life, that's what I just want to focus. You know, even though it's easy to say that that's okay or God be with you or something like that, but I wanted to make sure that I'm glad that you are in the Bible reading group, and Word of God will comfort you just like his presence. You know, just we heard from the reading of the Bible that Jesus went to prepare a place for us. He wants us not to trouble our hearts while we are on earth, because the things will fall in afar, but we have great hope in God. That is the greatest comfort that we have in our life. I just want to make sure that you follow that, Betty, these days. And, you know, everything well done, and a service was gone. And while you are alone at home, you will miss her so badly. So cling on to the Word of God. God's Word will comfort you. I'll be sure of that. So some things I just want to reflect on. Nancy's faith was so strong in God. I should be saying, because she's within 1.5 hours I spent with them on 11th of January. They shared all the life that they went through together, and when I visit with them, Betty make every, you know, time, like preparing everything to Nancy's to get ready and meet the chaplain. And second time when I went there, Betty told me that, Chaplain John, I'm so having a lot of trouble to leaving her because I know that she's dying, but I'm not able to understand and cope with the situation. I personally talked to her a few minutes and let her to understand the fact that we are going to face, and she said she'll be okay, and I'm 100% sure that you'll be okay with the presence of Martha and your close friends, and moreover, God will comfort you. God will give you that special grace to move on. I can comfort you. I can offer you with that. I just want to remind a couple of verses from the Bible. First is 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 13 through 18. It goes like this. But I do not want you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning those who have fallen asleep. Let you sorrow as others who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so God will bring with him those who sleep in Jesus. We know that Nancy was a good believer in Jesus, and one day when Jesus come back a second time, they will rise up. And that is the hope we have in God. And the whole chapter explaining about the believer how to behave when we come to this point on death. And we have great hope in God. We will not be following the worldly people. They don't know what happens after death. But we know what happens after death, so that we have the hope in God. Second, Revelation chapter 21, 4 to 7, as the Reverend Mike recited here, I just want to remind again one more time. And God will wipe away every tears from their eyes. There shall be no more death, no sorrow, no crying. There shall be no more pain, for the former things have passed away. Then he who sat on the throne said, Behold, I make all things new. And he said to me, Write, for these words are true and faithful. And he said to me, It's done. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give you fountain of water of freely to him who thirsts. He who overcomes shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he will be my children. Amen. And that's a promise of God. He will wipe away all our tears. His promises are yes and yes and amen. And God is always with you, Betty, and that is my prayer. Just all stand up together, word of God, as we're going to recite the Lord's Prayer. Let's all together do. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy will be done in honor. As it is in heaven, give us this daily bread. Forgive us trespassers, as we forgiven with them. Lead us in not temptations, but the power and the glory forever. And amen. Amen.
You may be seated. John, thank you so very, very, very much. And let us tune our ears and our hearts now to this next song that Nancy and Betty have chosen for us all to hear together now.
I didn't know today would be our last, or that I'd have to say goodbye to you so fast. I'm so numb, I can't feel anymore. it's not my place to question. Only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight. You always made my troubles feel so small, and you were always there to catch me when I'd fall. In a world where heroes come and go, well, God just took the only one I know. So I'll hold you
you to join your hearts with mine once more as we offer these words in prayer of thanksgiving and words of commendation as well. Let us pray. Jesus, our risen Lord, thank you for going before us into death to prepare the way. Thank you for being in our hearts and lives in this time of sorrow, for giving each of us our own experience of your love and the comfort of your Spirit's presence. Thank you for preparing and giving a place in the kingdom of God for Nancy. Thank you for receiving her unto yourself, that where you are, there she may be also. Thank you that there's great rejoicing and celebration as she has arrived safely at home with you, even as we mourn her loss today. We confess that we're even now feeling that pain of separation. Yet you give us and enable us to live in the assurance that she is safe and happy and complete in your keeping. Look with tenderness and love upon this family and all these friends as they too put their trust in you. Walk with us from this moment of sorrow as we begin to turn again to our everyday lives. Comfort us in our loneliness, strengthen us in our weakness, and give us courage to face the future unafraid. Draw those of us who remain closer to one another and help us to know that peace and joy which is eternal life. Assured by faith that Nancy's end is also her beginning, we commend her now to God's eternal home, where she has found her everlasting peace and joy, which the loving Lord has promised her. And all who believe in him will have the resurrection victory. We thank you, God, for your comforting love and for your victory of life over death through the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is Savior. Amen. Just a word for reception immediately following the benediction in just a moment. The family will go out, but they will go out this way to our left where you find the garden room. You may exit the way you came in, and we will be there for you to greet the family, have some moments of friendship and fellowship together as long as you want to. There are refreshments, and let's enjoy this time of each other, and especially of greeting Betty and other members of the family. Will you stand for this benediction? This service of grace and remembrance and comforting peace is now ended. But our faith in Jesus Christ, our Lord, goes on and on. May your faith be so real and your joy so obvious, so that all who see you will come to praise God. Now go in his peace. Amen. John will step down here.